I'm recording.
So what we got here is a Stanley steamer here, and
now it's a Mammoth. Where's the brand name? There's nothing on it, is there?
No, there's nothing.
I thought it said Mammoth on the side, but it is made by Mammoth. M-O-M-A-M-O-D.
Mammoth.
Maybe it's Mammoth. Yeah, that would be
run
the,
by. We got a little thing with the
white
there.
All we got in there is methyl hydrate to put in your gas tank to get rid of water. So dumped a little of that in. That seems to last forever. And heats that up. Steam's forced down into here. And the suction from the vacuum going up by that also helps draw it out.
You got your flywheel and then
you got
a grinding wheel.
If you gotta make some beer caps smaller, take a finish off of that.
What won't you think of next?
That's 100 years ago.
Yeah.
Or 150 years ago.
I have made big ones, they could actually do work with them.
The first
water.
One was what, 18?
Maybe you should come up with that idea.
Was 1810 or 1820 the first one? Something like that?
Maybe.
There was a Newcomen steam engine, but it used to grind to a halt after a while. The cylinder or something used to get full of water after a while, and then I think watts or something.
It could have.
He put heat, I think, on that part or something.
Hydrolock. Yeah.
I suppose this one just throws the water out, so it won't lock up anyway.
Probably guys want to put some oil on it once in a while.
Yeah.
This is how quick it responds to loss of heat.
Yeah, it slows it right down.
And then just like stepping on the gas pedal.
Pretty simple. You almost build something yourself and make it like bigger. You run it by wood or something.
Yeah.
Because they're all external heat. It's not really hard, but it's pretty cool though.
Yeah, if you were living off the grid and had to pump water out of a well or something, I would say we ran out of flame.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good enough for you though.
Well, you got a little film on there.
It's awesome.
She sure relies on the heat to keep it going.
Cool. Let's bring that over.
Mm-hmm.